A Dispatches reporter has uncovered a message of bigotry and intolerance spreading through Britain from the Saudi religious establishment.
We want to have children and offer them as soldiers. Put in their soft, tender heart the zeal of jihad.
Now he was to find more radical speakers, preaching in a mosque run by a major organization, praised by Tony Blair for its interfaith work. While filming undercover, our reporter met this preacher, Dr. Ijaz Mian. He's a traveling speaker who talks at different organizations in Britain. Our reporter filmed his talk at a mosque run by the Ala Hadith organization in Derby. It's the same organization that runs Green Lane Mosque in Birmingham, which our reporter found promoting extreme teachings. Dr. Mian praises the Saudi religious police, saying they can imprison people for not praying.
They send the police and they say, well, if you don't come for prayer, close your shop, we will arrest you. But if you don't, then we have to bring the punishment on you. You will be killed and nobody will pray on you.
Dr. Mian is yet another UK preacher who has taught in Saudi Arabia. He spent 6 years studying Islam in Ibn Saud University in Riyadh. He wants to see religious police operating on the streets.
They would make sure that every person prays to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Five times. Every woman will be covered. From the top to the toes. Hijab. Otherwise the police will just correct them.
He has a radical plan for this country. Muslims shouldn't accept British democracy.
Everywhere, king, queen, house of commons, if you accept it, then you're a part of it. You don't accept it, but you have to dismantle it. So you being a Muslim, you have to fix it up. There is no what you call house of commons. From that white house to this black house, we know that we have to dismantle it.
Muslims must grow in strength, then take over.
You are in a what you call situation in which you have to live like a state within a state till you take over. But until this happens, you have to preach. Or you become in such a force that the people, they just submit to you. Hands up. Till you become strong enough that to take over.
It's an extreme vision that Muslims will one day take over Britain and bring about an Islamic state with Sharia law. Dr. Mian invites our reporter to visit Birmingham, where he's based.
We can come to you, you can come to us.
He takes him up on the offer. And a few weeks later, they meet in Birmingham. Dr. Mian takes him to Sparkbrook Islamic Centre, where he wants to arrange a talk. The centre is run by the UK Islamic Mission, a major organisation dedicated to interfaith work. This is their annual conference last year in Birmingham. It runs over 45 mosques and branches in Britain and has 6,000 children in its part-time Islamic schools. The Prime Minister has said the UKIM is extremely valued by the government, particularly for its multi-faith and multicultural activities. Yet despite his radical views, Dr. Mian has worked with the UKIM and given talks at its events. At their annual conference, he was a guest on stage. Today, he's making a presentation to the UKIM committee at the Sparkbrook Islamic Centre. He suggests that the committee invites a small group of non-Muslims to the mosque and tries to convert them.
Every kafir has a right to Islam.
He says Muslims cannot accept non-Muslim rule.
You cannot accept the rule of the kafir, kufr. We have to rule ourselves and we have to rule others.
Although his radical beliefs are obvious, the UKIM committee is happy to go ahead with his talk.
Yeah, we invite people. Will you be available to speak to them?
Of course,
this is my full time duty.
Yeah, that's
the UKIM hosts regular interfaith events at this mosque. Yet when our reporter joined the worshippers at Sparkbrook for a Friday sermon, he heard the UKIM imam preaching against non-Muslims.
God, help us win the fight against the kuffar in every field, in every department of life. We beg you to help us fight against the enemies of our religion. Help us fight the kuffar.
The UKIM runs Dawa, or missionary centres, which spread the word. Our reporter visits one of them, at Alum Rock Islamic Centre in Birmingham, to see what kind of materials they circulate.
Is the Dawa Centre open upstairs?
Yes, what do you want?
I'm looking for some books.
Okay, yes.
He's given some free leaflets.
One can use this one.
Okay.
You start with these.
Okay,
problem. These are easy to understand for everybody who don't know anything about Islam.
They're by a Pakistani religious leader called Saeed Madhudi. He was the founder of a fundamentalist political party in Pakistan called Jamaat Islami. The UKIM literature outlines his radical message.
Islam is a revolutionary ideology which seeks to alter the social order of the entire world.
Muslims form an international revolutionary party. The pamphlets contain some of the ideas that Dr. Mian preaches, that Muslims must work towards doing away with all non-Islamic governments and set up an Islamic state. The party Madhudi founded, the Jamaat Islami, has links with the Saudi religious establishment. Although it stands in Pakistani elections, its aim is to set up an Islamic state run by Sharia law. The man who runs the missionary centre in Birmingham says the UKIM is an independent organisation with its own objectives. But he says they follow the same ideology as the Jamaat Islami.
Ideologically, we are affiliated with Jamaat Islami.
It's the same ideology?
You can say that. It's the same ideology.
He claims the UKIM shares the same ideology with other fundamentalist organisations, like Hamas in Palestine and the Muslim Brotherhood in Egypt.
Some are in Pakistan, some are in Egypt, or some are in wherever they are. Their ideology is same. So you can say our ideology is same with them.
Thank you very much.
Our reporter finds the UKIM accepts money from Saudi sheikhs. Every week at its Sparkbrook Mosque, a list of donors is read out.
Saudi Arabian professor, Sheikh.
Our reporter attended a day of talks arranged at the UKIM Sparkbrook Mosque. When we contacted the UKIM, they said they had hired their centre out to another organisation who arranged this event. In public, the UKIM has told Muslims they can participate in British democracy, and it invited politicians to its annual conference last summer in Birmingham.
I'm here as a friend of Islam, and as a Labour politician.
But in the day of talks in their mosque, invited preachers condemned democracy.
Today we find ourselves bearing the brunt of a pervasive attack against Islam, trying to win the hearts and the minds of the Muslimin over to become advocates and supporters of a democratic system. Then never will the Jews and the Christians be happy with you until you follow their way, and you follow their system, and you follow their way of life. Call the people to avoid and renounce the millah of the Jews and the Christians, which is a millah of freedom, which is a millah of equality, which is a millah of democracy.
The next speaker is introduced as the deputy headmaster of Darul Uloom Islamic High School, a single-faith secondary school in Birmingham. The government has urged single-faith schools to promote tolerance, inclusion and understanding between different sections of society.
They talk about integration. There's an old word as well as a cold word. Plan, a program. They talk about you need to integrate. If you don't, then you're a freak.